One of the novel concepts in our trends paper is host-mediated artificial selection on microbiomes, which I can illustrate using a plant example from an ongoing experiment. I will use a plant example, but the same principles also apply to selection on microbiomes of animals. For example, gut microbiomes of honeybees that we're also trying to evolve in my lab, or gut microbiomes of mice or domesticated animals, as we show in figure 1 of our trends paper. Suppose you have a population of plants like these 8 plants from a selection line in my experiment, and suppose you would like to artificially select for fast growth or health in this population of plants. If there are heritable differences in plant genes underlying the total phenotypic variation, then you can increase the average growth of plants in this population by breeding the next generation of plants from the largest plants on the right, while excluding from breeding the smaller plants at the left. Such artificial selection works because the largest plants are most likely to carry genetic material that promote large growth. Now, in my selection experiment here, all plants in this population are genetically identical, so the phenotypic variation in this population cannot be due to genetic differences between these plants, but the variation is due to environmental factors, such as small uncontrolled differences in light level or soil moisture experienced by these plants, or perhaps due to associated microbiomes that may differ between these individual plants. While it is not possible to select on the non-living environmental factors such as light level or soil moisture, it is possible to select on the associated microbiomes, for example, on the root-associated microbiomes. To do this, I harvest root-associated microbiomes from well-growing plants, then transfer these harvested microbiomes to sterile soil planted with seeds of the next plant microbiome generation, like these 6-day-old plants that are inoculated with harvested microbiomes at the time of seed germination. That is, I artificially select for beneficial microbiomes by co-propagating the plants with specific microbiomes. In my selection experiment, this plant microbiome co-propagation process is host-mediated because I use the host to both gauge and manipulate the microbiome. And the artificial selection is indirect because I never measure the microbiome properties directly. Instead, I only measure features of the host plant, like number of leaves or overall size, to identify those plants that are most likely to associate with microbiomes that promote growth, which here would be the largest plants. In essence, after ranking my plants by size, I harvest the root-associated microbiomes from the largest plants, filter these microbiomes to exclude fungal pathogens, then transfer these filtered microbiomes to plants of the next plant microbiome generation. Using repeated rounds of plant microbiome co-propagation under controlled environmental conditions, I therefore artificially select for beneficial microbiomes through host-mediated indirect selection. If you have questions about host-mediated selection on microbiomes, or if you'd like to learn some of the experimental tricks that we use to select on microbiomes, see boxes 2 and 3 in our Trends article or email me at the University of Texas at Austin.